Are we alone in the universe? This question has occupied the minds of scientists for centuries. It has ignited our imagination and pushed us to the frontiers of the unknown. But what if the answer is much closer than we think? What if what we're looking for is within our own galaxy, just a whisper away? What if I told you about a planet exactly 120 light years away from us that could be covered in oceans? And what if I told you that in its atmosphere, we found a gas that on Earth is almost exclusively produced by living organisms? The famous astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson has explored this topic in depth. Because a planet named K2-18b, exactly 120 light years away, has sent what is essentially a challenge to the scientific world. The James Webb Space Telescope found something in this planet's atmosphere that didn't just make headlines, it made us question the most fundamental assumptions of science. This could potentially be the strongest evidence for life to date, but science doesn't like to rush. So, for the next 7 minutes, let's peel back the layers of this incredible discovery, one by one, and examine the evidence, the doubts, and what the truth might be. So how do we know what's in the atmosphere of a planet billions of kilometers away? The answer lies in an ingenious method called transit spectroscopy. When a planet passes in front of its own star, some of the starlight filters through the planet's atmosphere to reach us. As Neil deGrasse Tyson humorously puts it, the planet's atmosphere contaminates the light from the star. Each chemical element, like a ghost, absorbs specific colors of light or wavelengths. James Webb's sensitive detectors then identify these missing colors, these chemical fingerprints. And K2-18b, viewed with this method, was a very special candidate. It's not rocky like Earth, nor a gas giant like Neptune. It's in between, in a mysterious category called a sub-Neptune. And most importantly, it was known to have a puffy atmosphere. This means it has a massive atmosphere made of hot, light gases that extends higher against gravity. This gave us much more material to analyze. When scientists looked at this planet's atmosphere, they found what they expected. But then, something they never expected emerged. The first big clue was methane gas. Now, you might say, wait a minute, methane is everywhere. You're absolutely right. But this is where context comes into play. It's not the mere presence of a chemical that matters, but the conditions and quantity in which it is found. Here's the critical point. If K2-18b is indeed such an ocean world, there shouldn't be this much methane in its atmosphere. The strong ultraviolet radiation from its star would easily break methane down. For such a high concentration of methane to persist, there must be a source constantly producing it in massive quantities. Geological processes can't explain that much. But what about biological processes? Just like in the depths of Earth's oceans, microorganisms living in oxygen-free environments, in other words, life. The presence of methane alone, in this scenario, would be a strong indicator of life. But wait, that's not the real bombshell. In the telescope's data, there was another molecule that truly shocked scientists, one that made them say, if this is real, dimethyl sulfide, or DMS for short. You might actually be familiar with this molecule. It's part of that familiar smell of the sea you get at the ocean's edge. But on Earth, as far as we know, DMS has only one large-scale natural producer, phytoplankton, in the oceans. These are the microscopic organisms that perform photosynthesis and produce a significant portion of our planet's oxygen. Now, get ready for this. Scientists didn't just find DMS on K2-18b. They found it in a concentration 10,000 to 100,000 times denser than on Earth. This is a mind-boggling figure. If this data is correct, and if some exotic chemistry we don't know about isn't producing this molecule, this could mean that the oceans on that planet are teeming with life. This is like a giant life exists here sign. Okay, let's set the excitement aside. This is the point where, as Neil deGrasse Tyson emphasizes in his programs, we need to put on our scientist hats. Extraordinary claims require extraordinary evidence. So, what are the doubts about this discovery? First, the strength of the data. This discovery was announced with a 3 sigma confidence level in statistics. This means the probability of the data being random noise is 1 in 10 hundred. Sounds good, but the gold standard in science is 5 sigma, where the chance of being wrong is 1 in 3.5 million. As Tyson's guest, David Kipping, also noted, many discoveries at the 2 and 3 sigma level have disappeared when better data arrived. So that small signal could just be noise in the telescope's data. Second, alternative explanations. We know that on Earth, DMS is only produced by living things. But does that have to be true for the rest of the universe? Couldn't strange geological or photochemical processes that we don't know about be producing this molecule? For instance, traces of DMS were found on the comet 67P, which the Rosetta spacecraft landed on a dead celestial body. Also, what if K2-18b isn't an ocean world but just a gas giant with no surface? In that case, the unimaginable high pressures and temperatures in the planet's depths could be producing these chemicals. In short, a single magic molecule cannot be considered definitive proof of life. So, what's the conclusion? What do we have? On one hand, a planet that offers incredibly strong, multiple chemical clues for life. On the other hand, the justified scientific skepticism that says, let's not get ahead of ourselves, this could be an illusion. This is one of the most beautiful moments in science. This isn't a fight, it's a symphony. Just as Neil deGrasse Tyson points out at every opportunity, science isn't a list of results, it's a process. This is the beginning of a conversation that moves forward with more data and better questions. So what happens now? The answer is simple, more data. The scientific community will ask for the James Webb telescope to be pointed at K2-18b again for longer observations to determine for certain whether these signals are real or a phantom. Perhaps in a few years, K2-18b will be remembered as the planet that changed human history, or maybe just as an exciting false alarm. But whatever happens, the search continues. Because this search is not just about finding life in space, it's also about understanding our own place in the universe. What do you think? Could there be life on K2-18b? Or is this just exaggerated data? Share your theories in the comments. To not miss out on scientific adventures like this, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like the video. See you in the next discovery. Stay in the light of science.